Next speaker is Scott Honor, running for governor. And then Marty Seifert will be following that.
Thanks so much. Good morning. Minnesota is a great state. We have abundant resources, we have terrific talent, but we're underachieving our potential. And I see that happening because we have too many career politicians who focus on how much money we spend instead of the results we get. They accept mediocrity instead of striving for excellence. And we have a governor more focused on do-overs than on moving this state forward. You know, he raised taxes by $2 billion, then repealed $500 million. Do-over. He subsidized the Viking Stadium with a funding plan that didn't work, then he did his due diligence after he signed the contract. Do-over. He approved a $90 million Senate office building that he later called too extravagant. Yep, do-over. He was against medical marijuana, then he was for it, then he thought we should study it. Then he suggested we buy drugs illegally on the street. Now he's not sure about that. Do-over. And he embraced Obamacare more than any governor in this country. We spent $150 million to build a website that doesn't work to support a fundamentally flawed federal program. Now he's looking for a blank check bailout. Another do-over. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to tell you that Governor Dayton's do-over days are done. But the problem isn't just the governor. We have too many Republican leaders who go along with the plan of funding failed DFL programs. The Minshew is the perfect example. Now, why should we pay for Obamacare twice? We didn't want it in the first place. We had to pay for it with federal tax dollars. Now our legislature has passed $400 million of additional spending of state dollars to support Obamacare in Minnesota. That makes no sense to me. Yet I am the only candidate who's called for shutting down Minshew and stopping this ongoing bailout of Obamacare. Now, we need a different kind of leadership in St. Paul, and that's why I'm running for governor. I'm looking to take my private sector experience to put this state back on the right track. Now, in business, to be successful, we had to start by having a vision of where we wanted to go, a plan of how to get there, put in place the right team, get everyone on board, measure results, and then refine as we went along. Well, that approach is exactly what's missing in St. Paul. And that's exactly the approach I'll take as governor. And to be successful, we had to set priorities. I'll set priorities for this state. We'll start by improving the economy, creating more jobs, and moving people from welfare to work. And we'll do that by reforming regulation, reducing taxes, and making Minnesota a right-to-work state. We'll improve education and make sure that our students have the best chance to have a career or go to college. We'll do that by offering more school choice, have dollars follow the student, make sure that local schools can pay teachers and reward the best teachers based on performance by eliminating tenure. And we'll cut administrative costs and get those dollars into the classroom. And then we'll shrink government and get better results. You know, in Minnesota today, we spend 2.5 times as much per citizen as we did in 1980. That's in real inflation-adjusted, apples-to-apples dollars. We've got to go the other way. I know from my business experience, you can always find a way to lower costs and get better outcomes. That's the approach I'll take to St. Paul. Now, I'm not looking for a career in politics. I just want to get in there and get the big things that need doing done. I look forward to earning your support. I want to work together to see Minnesota achieve her full potential. God bless you, and God bless the great state of Minnesota.